Oh, you've experienced the desert. It's kind of like Old Faithful, you know, it's always there. Always faithful. But that's just me. I'm sure that you have your own favorite devotional, and when you share them with your emotions or in e-format, meaning internet, or in some expression digitally, then it's kind of like an emotional. And in this journey of a year, you know, to get 8 devotionals recorded, you know, of observations of the two of us, whoever you may be and me, and the Lord, so 3, sharing and caring to challenge each other to do them daily, then it becomes like a mutual covenant or a agreement between us to help each other to discover what it is that God may say each and every day of our life, at least for 1 year. After that, you're on your own. But in Streams in the Desert, you have to have a sense of humor. After all, we get up every morning and meet each other every day. This is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. 1 John 5:4. It is easy to love him when the blue is in the... I try not to read all the poems. Okay, we'll skip the poems. To trust in spite of the look of being forsaken, to keep crying out into the vast whence comes no returning voice, where seems no hearing, to see the machinery of the world pauselessly grinding on as if self-moved, caring for no life, nor shifting a hair's breadth for all entreaty, and yet believe that God is awake and utterly loving, to desire nothing but what comes meant for us from his hand, to wait patiently, ready to die of hunger, fearing only lest faith should fail, such is the victory that overcomes the world, such is faith indeed. You know, it's easy when you see the results of your faith. You know, it's like, I try to tell people that, you know, my faith is not just experiential, but it's demonstrative in the sense of I treat it as a experiment in life that I'm able to put into this module, the scriptures, and then put into it what God says, his promises, and then see if there's results. And if the results are measurable, then I know that they're real. And that's called a scientific module. It's where you can prove or demonstrate that something is true in this physical realm that we live in. And for me, I've done that. Now for you, the only way to prove that God is real is to find out for yourself. You can't live on someone else's faith. I mean, it may be nice that if you were raised in a Christian family or a religious family or wherever you are, or whatever faith you're in, that you think that you can be a part of that faith that your family had, that tradition or that religious upbringing. But the truth is, no matter what religion you're in or what faith you have, that kind of experience is what we call vicarious. You're living through someone else's experience. You're not doing it yourself. So until you're personal about it, like until, say you're not a Christian and you're living in some other faith, until you prove to yourself the truth or the untruth of that faith that you're living in, you'll never know. Because you're just going along for the ride. You're just participating in what everyone else is doing. It's partially religious peer pressure. In a lot of ways, that's what most of the world does, is that 9 times out of 10, I meet people that say they are either a Catholic or a Protestant or a Muslim or you name it. I mean, a Hindu or a Hindi or a, you know, of course that's not a religion, but a Buddhist or a whatever it may be. And when you get to talking to them, you find out, no, it's something that they heard and they like, not something that they believe in. And so you have to prove for yourself and demonstrate to yourself whether God is real. Now, for me, I have no doubt. Jesus said certain things that I proved to be true in my life, and he proved them to me by demonstrating that he was real and that he could be proven to myself in a way that I understood, so that way I could put my faith, the rest of what I am proving from his word, into practice and into reality, so that I could see it happening in this life as I live it. And so I did. And so it's true. And for me, of course I'm a Christian. Of course I follow Jesus. Of course, because he's real and alive and living, not only in the world around me and the things that happen to me, which could be called kismet, but because he's in me and I hear his voice and I walk with him and I talk with him each day. And that's what a person has to do in order to become a disciple of Jesus. You have to be born beyond what you can see. You have to become more than what you can touch and feel. You have to become born of the Spirit and become born again. Because Jesus said it, and in order to find out what he meant, you would have to do it. So once you do it, you can prove it, and then if it does work for you, then you know it's real. If it doesn't work for you, hey, you know, I can't tell you what God has in store for you, but I can tell you that you can try it and see. No offense, sounds terrible, but try it, you just might like it. And if God had said that there's a determination to be made between eternity with him or eternity without him, I think I would choose to try it and see if God is real and prove beyond any shadow of a doubt to yourself, one way or the other. You know, if you don't want to be a Christian, fine. That's not a problem for me. It's like, hey, I told you what you can do with it. You know, you can go ahead and prove it to yourself or don't. But I went out of my way to prove that God is real, and he did. He revealed himself to me. When you choose to do the same, when you really choose to prove that God is real, you'll find, beyond any shadow of a doubt, without anybody telling you how to, what to, or where to, or any other explanation, when you commit that to God, literally, get down on your knees or down on your face or bow down or stand up or raise your hands, whatever it is, when you get alone and no one around and you decide to prove that God is real, then he reveals himself to you. Until you do that, I hate to say it, but you're probably just dealing with peer pressure, religious pressure, and you're living vicariously on someone else's experiences and someone else's faith and not proving to yourself what is real and who, more than anything else, who is real.